Here goes Carey, putting it in off the window. Can't get it to go. Amon's there.
The top guards in the country, a freshman, also from DeMatha.
Stephen Enoch, a little bit out of his range. Here's Enoch trying to go to work on Sumbury inside. Little baby jump hook comes up short.
That out of their half court where they get the ball down low. Let's see if they can score in the paint.
Steve Enoch into the game, short on the jump hook. Gilbert, Jackson, the quick release on the left side, halfway down, and that comes out. Stephen Enoch can't get it to go, but Jalen Adams finally does.
Great basketball.
Double figures.
Starts with the penetration by Cooper off the ball screen, splitting the defense.
Bill Hamilton in Los Angeles. Enoch trying to go to work. Stays with it. A third time, and the third time is the charm. 0 of 5 from the field in the game against Wagner. There's Murphy inside getting the bucket, and the foul is going to have a chance at a conventional three-point play as the foul is on Enoch.
He's trying to open up the court a little bit more. Now he's got his power team in the lineup with Enoch and Facey.
Enoch called for the offensive foul.
Team defensively, 5-1.
All right, take it back. They gave the bucket to Begley. There's Enoch working inside. Can't get it to go. It's up fake. Terry Larrier in traffic, and there's Stephen Enoch. There's the easy high percentage shots that Kevin Ollie wants to see.
I'll say, you have your facts correct out here. Gary, things not be so fair out here when you come out from the East Coast.
Mayo dipping under, can't get it to fall, but the foul is on Stephen Enoch.
I'm trying to take it the length of the floor. The ball is loose.
How is there no contact? How is there no call on that either charge block play in the middle of the lane? Player off your bench? That's a luxury not many teams have.
Enoch with a baseline jumper, no.
That's big time.
And three straight buckets for Oklahoma State to open up the lead, and now another Connecticut turnover. And look at those numbers. They're playing together now, Carroll and Waters. Talented players filling a similar role for Oklahoma State. Enoch with a power move inside.
An Oregon game. From Icy, he'll play more and more because
Kevin, turnaround Adams off the back of the iron, and the foul going against Enoch over the back. At the last game of the day here in the Valley, you'll see that game on ESPN2 as Roy Williams Tar Heels will take the court against the host school.
Ultimately going to wear you down. They've got so many big guys, and their freshman big guy Tony Bradley has come in right away.
Adams, nice bounce pass, and Enoch missed the dunk. Back into the gym. Thank God for the TV timeout. Gasol turns it over and then commits a foul. No, could.
The ball.
6'11", 258. Enoch for three.
At the Maui gym. The three rattles out from Kieran Shastri. And there's a foul going for the rebound, and it's against UConn, and Stephen Enoch, three for Rodney Purvis.
You got to get a rebound if you expect to win. Standing out of bounds.
On the end line is Stephen Enoch.
Don't have a matching tie with
him. I do not have a matching tie. It's doctor's orders.
Jalen Adams pushes for the Huskies.
Transition opportunity, Jalen. Adams just so smooth, so strong.
Dropped in by Stephen Enoch.
What was the halftime score last night against North Carolina?
Whoa.
Stephen Enoch. Long three in transition is off the mark from Danley Walker. And a steal ahead of the pack is Stephen Enoch. And he slams it home. Sam Daly.
Beautiful.
Off the heel of the rim, can't get it to go. Enoch stepping out.
He's given his life over there on the main island of Oahu, one of 8 islands. Going to step down
every major conference in college basketball. Offensive foul.
Oregon's playing perfect. UConn is not in this rhythm yet.
And a turnover, a poor pass from
junior college in Wyoming.
Dylan Brooks to the basket. And one. Rodney Purvis.
Beautiful.
And the follow. Chris Boucher from the corner. And it's cleared by Enoch.
2-4 on the season. BU at 4-2. And there's Stephen Enoch. It was halfway down and it rolled out. Rebound. Adams knifing through. Enoch, offensive glass, and he's hit going up. Steven Enoch shooting free throws at 75% on the season.
Well, he doesn't have a lot of options, as we've talked about. He's got eight players. So.
Adams and Vitale and Purvis, and Enoch right to the rim, the bucket and the foul.
Trap in the middle of the floor. That time BU got out of their game plan, and UConn made him pay for it.
Say early in the second half. And an errant pass by Enoch. Enoch facing up, going to work on Alston. Big body and gets it to go. The jump hook in the lane. We need to see more of that, Tim. I think Kevin Ollie needs to see more of that with the shot clock under 10. And there's going to be a foul on Steven Enoch. Into the land of the Giants, giving it up for Alston, reversing. Enoch got a piece of it. Alston tries to stay with it. Up fake, pass Purvis. And it's Steven Enoch who wrestles it away for UConn. 3 of 13 as they go inside to Steven Enoch with the shot clock at 10. Enoch losing it. Fanning crossing over to the left hand. That one won't go down. And another rebound for Enoch. Teason Scanlon doing what he does best. That's long range shoot. Can't get it to go, but Mosley is bumped on the rebound. Tim, he thinks this is a winnable game for his team. There's Fanning drawing contact and getting the bucket to go off the window.
It's going to be enough for Steven Enoch, for Kenton Facey and Mita Brina to do all the rebounding by themselves.
Enoch goes in. Brina went for the tip again. Now the fall away, and that one drop and a shove underneath. And a foul against UConn.
And Jim Boeheim, we're all alone picking up our stuff in the garden. There's nobody here. Jim Boeheim walked from behind the scorers to touches to get the ball more to the rim rather than settling for jump shots.
On a low block, he knocked very quickly. Two efforts there, gets back a third and draws the foul.
It was amazing defense.
He knocked off tack. He is 6'11". He's coming up 26 points against North Florida. And a victory for the Orange. Here's Purvis trying to answer, and he does.
If they're going to switch that, you got to punish him for that.
Howard to the paint. Block and a foul. They're going to get Enoch for that one. Enoch hooks it.
And a whistle away from the ball. An offensive foul. That's against Steve Enoch. Now the inbound pass. It was right to Jaquan Lyle. 5 points so far. Steven Enoch up with the left hand. It falls off the rim.
You really watch how defenses get broken down. Look for that to happen in the next few possessions for Ohio State offensively.
Another assist here, although it doesn't go. Fighting for the rebound, Trevor Thompson is fouled.
Dude, those things are light.
They provide warmth. Train of defenders there.
When bigs put it on the deck, when a big puts it on the deck, he's not driving to pass the ball. He's driving to put it up.
But he's not Armenian.
Really?
They have the corner. Cross-court pass. Three on the way from Cam Williams. Doesn't fall.
Especially with Amita Brima.
Three from the top. Misses long.
Get him out because that's when they pick up fouls.
Purvis the long two. Rims out from 18 feet. And as Tate went up for that rebound, he was called for the foul. Shot clock winding down. Adams looks to make a move. Passes it down low, and it will be Enoch going to the free throw line. As we were told, UConn goes as Jalen Adams does. Not being able to make anything from behind the three-point line. 2 for 16 tonight. And here's Tate. Lost the ball and it still almost went in. Enoch again trying to make his move to the basket and he traveled. Jaquan Lyle trying to dribble around the defense, looking for an opening. Finds Thompson, who's fouled on the dunk attempt.
Really stay on the hip.
UConn hadn't scored in 5 minutes.
Per game on the season, that's tops in the American Conference. Very soft baby hook by Steven Enoch team. Kenton Facey was not feeling well at the Garden against Syracuse. Little left hand hook inside. And look at Enoch, the ability, Tim, to go to the offhand. Five. Banks. Wild hook shot. He's bailed out right there by Enoch. But his coach, Matthew Driscoll, believes that he is going to be an NBA player. That
big guy can just catch it and make a move.
Bodicher dumping inside, and Banks can't finish. And then top it off, he commits the foul. Adams. Enoch cannot hang on to another one. Attacking. Has it rejected, but off the offensive glass there. Steven Enoch at the buzzer.
Looks at the rim.
It's a big foul because it's the third on the big man, Amita Brima. He takes a seat, and Steven Enoch is in. Coming in, averaging just about 7 a game. He's got 3 so far as Sams loses it. Ox. Right on cue. There goes Banks. Nice spin move of the game for North Florida. UConn has 9. Enoch going to the left hand. Too hard off the back iron. Fights for the offensive rebound and then is hit by Odom. Around the rim.
Well, yes, and he catches the ball most of the time. And a nice roll to the rim by Facey.
That's a new career high now for Kenton Facey. 15-footer on the way, around and out. He is yet to score. Enoch
playing more of an up-tempo style this afternoon.
Dallas Moore cannot get that one to go. It's away, Vance Jackson. For Steven Enoch.
You have to pay better attention to the three-point line.
Ill-advised by Nick Malunga. Birdie coming out of his hands right back the other way, Dallas Moore, and he's suddenly gone cold, and Enoch is knocked out of bounds by his own teammate, Jalen Adams.
Player movement, unselfish basketball.
He's got 11 points and 10 assists off the rejection. 5 rebounds on the afternoon. Enoch, mid-range.
Bounds, Dunnins trying to do it himself. The lefty, no. Another 3 on the way. That one off, and a good defensive rebound position for Steven Enoch.
Younger players, about how hard you have to play, I would think that he's trying to get someone to compete.
Take that 3, penetrates, free throw line, jumper, no good. Big rebound there, and it's Enoch who comes away with it.
They've had great, great big men, but Grime is a guy that never developed a personality offensively. See, to me, I think when you think of bigs off.
Purvis off balance, long 3, big rebound by Enoch down low, and he gets it to go. Do they call the walk on him?
All right, and attack Connecticut by moving the ball in people as opposed to
poorly set to be only 1 point down. It feels like this could be a 10-point game.
It should be, but the one
they're 3 of 11 from three-point land
and early threes, Ravi, and that's a problem.
Enoch gets it to go, and he's going to go to the line.
As long as he's playing hard and he's competing, his offense will come around. He's got a big body. All right, you've got to find a way to utilize his strengths for your teammate. Right now, Auburn's not making any plays for each other.
Enoch also said recently, Seth, as he gets that one to go.
To bowl to Purvis or to Enoch on the block. There it is to Enoch.
Against
beautiful.
Wiley, and the fadeaway drops.
Shot selection. They can't settle, and then they got to find somehow, some way to establish someone in the low block. Games in 9 days and been on the road a long period of time. This will be a challenge for Auburn.
Kevin Ollie showing some real support for Enoch, who works his way into the lane.
Terrific play by Wiley. You're talking about walling up, hands straight up, verticality once again right into the block. North Florida, but no one on this Connecticut team has done it before.
There's a block from Enoch. Empty possessions for Connecticut, and the foul on Enoch. Run here for Houston. Gray in the middle, and he missed the teardrop. Call foul underneath on Steven Enoch. And Rover halftime report. Big one on the ACC at 7 tonight. Enoch turnaround, can't get it to go. Jackson to Facey on the baseline. No good. Enoch threw it away. Good pass down low. Dunk is missed by Colley. And that's a terrible call. There was no defensive effort even made by Enoch, and yet they get a whistle, pen, and all that. Sampson, a lot of college coaches rather talk baseball than hoop.
Staying with it in the second half, just moving the ball, being patient. Now,
good ball fake and a good release, but no result.
Adams to the post. Enoch able to roll it home.
Who can take Facey outside?
Foul on the block defensively on Enoch. Purvis has barely been out. Foul offensively away from the ball. It's on Enoch. Taplin. Enoch ahead for Adams. Axon off the mark. Rebound Facey. Rips it in, and the dunk no good for Enoch. 41-36 nearing the midpoint second half. Turnaround shot blocked as Igbani went up, and Enoch commits his 4th.
Dedicated to developing young people. both on and off the floor.
Steven Enoch misses off the bench from point blank range. And here, top three here from Lawson. That will not go.
This conference. And if they can get half the teams, almost half their teams.
Yeah, Shemi Ojale had another big game last night in SMU's victory for 2 years. Adams up top this time. It's Enoch.
Gives UConn some newfound life. Mm-hmm.
Diedrich muscling inside. Got it to go and a foul.
Minus nine. As Memphis has only turned the ball over twice, and UConn
driving Davis over the outstretched arm of Enoch, and a foul on the rebound. Formerly the Hartford Civic Center, now the XL Center. Screen by Fall, and a foul on the drive.
And if you're UConn, and they're going to have a good chance to win.
Steven Enoch inside, guarded by Mark Williams. Enoch over Williams for two. Enoch had only played 16 minutes in the last three games combined, but he gets on the board here in the first half. Eastern only on the 24-hour home of CBS Sports. Adams had to put up a three as the shot clock expired. UConn gets it back. Jackson feeds Enoch. Turnaround shot won't go, and Dingle clears. Adams feeds Enoch. Double team. Enoch puts it up. No call. In the American. Enoch using his strength, and he's fouled. Going up. The eight.
He looks bigger than 250.
Makes one out of two. We go over to Swin Cash.
23 points in the game and pulled down 10 rebounds. Mosley has it stripped by Enoch. And Connecticut throws it out of play. Jackson. Now Enoch, turnaround jump shot in the paint, and he's fouled by Hayes. From Norwalk, Connecticut, St. Thomas More. He's got great size.
This, as a young freshman, as a big, you have to learn and mature.
He had 10 boards against Temple the other day. Adams across town traffic finds Enoch, rejected by Pryor.
Wind.
And Kevin fouled on the rebound. For UConn, Adams, beautiful handle, nice look. Enoch with the flush. Pryor lost it, gets it back, and he is tied up. Possession arrow favoring Connecticut. Great players have worn this Connecticut jersey as Enoch misses.
Napier, so many talented players have come through the doors. Stores Connecticut.
Vance Jackson, Enoch powers his way inside and banks it down. 8, 34. Six rebounds, six assists. Nine to shoot. Adams. Baseline. Enoch. Here we go. 130. Enoch. And foul from the free throw line this season. Both free throws good for Enoch. Draws a double. Finds a cutting. Mosley blocked from behind by Enoch.
Calls for the Huskies. Travel. Foul in the lane. Believe that's going to go on Steven Enoch, and it will.
He's not as effective.
On the baseline, Enoch. That's his first points since January 14th versus Georgetown. Holston off the bounce. Just down to the post. Enoch facing up on Santos. Kick out Rodney Purvis. Another one rattles home for Rodney Purvis.
He's got him this one.
Ziegler attacking. Count the bucket and a foul. There's a reason you get to 0-11.
Then you come in here, the Anthem Pavilion.
Enoch back and in. That's an offensive foul. But play on, so instead of a four.
Far, but after your NBA career and your playing career, how special is it still to be, you know, one-on-one though between Mike versus Michael?
With, you know, new guy. Rookies are first year guys, but he loves Sham God, and he's doing an excellent job. And the team's getting better.
35-4. 10 minutes. It's 11 minutes before they get a hoop. Points a game. You can do a better job tonight on that. Nice look. Patel down the step back on the offensive glass. Enoch. the high post. Enoch, nice touch.
Juwan Durham feeds the post. Your Stephen Enoch lost the handle.
Shut off.
He would have heard it from Adams. I promise you, Williams misfires. Fall. And that'll be the tie-up. Horton. Williams blocked by Enoch. Chad Brown got it back, and he gets fouled by Enoch.
Lenny mentioned Purvis and Adams trying to get going, and another miss. And a UConn foul. And give it to Memphis.
Which has kind of packed it in against Memphis. Think again.
Stephen Enoch in off the bench. Foot or two behind the three-point line.
And you can see
a prolific three-point shooting team. Randall's a 30% shooter on the season.
Outing him as a shooter.
Shot clock down to 8. Enoch in the lane to his left, swatted from behind by Dingle. Purvis, who can run real hot and cold. Tough rebound by Enoch underneath, and he'll draw the foul. Foul line, just 14 out of 28.
4-1.
I think there's Big East in 2011, and it was UConn that year at 9-9.
Wing it. Rose. Sky's up there, and he draws the foul. He'll be at the line for two. Purvis gets hot second half. Adams with a floating pass. On the spin, a hook shot up and in. That's beautifully done. Here's the point guard at 6'3 out of Roxbury, Mass. Gives it off, and that jumper is rounded out by Enoch. 11 points and 12 assists. Rose with a floater. That one-hander won't go. And now a whistle and a foul on the collision. Well, that ends an 8-0 run by UConn. They'll blow the whistle. A foul's going to go the other way, and that one against Connecticut.
Robinson Jr. goes to work and goes around Jackson. And a blocking foul in the lane. Under 16, 7-2 UConn. Down to 5, Adams. The 3, Adams. Inside, Stephen Enoch.
He's got 99.
Here's Enoch with a face-up, and it goes down.
Much involved yet in the offense. That's a good thing.
Enoch. Enoch has 6 off the bench.
Holy cow. Big time in this game.
Jackson slicing in, drops it down for Enoch. Tied up by Myers. Davis spins out. Knowles, handoff, back door, never caught there. Enoch recovers.
We faced one ranked team this season.
I'll tell you what, I bet you any of those ranked teams don't want to deal with this guy.
Going to have to knock down for UConn.
Tyson on the drive. Juwan Durham came over late to alter that shot.
Defense and pick and roll defense. That was a concern in this game, in particular with Adams.
Adams coming on a curl, and it'll be an offensive foul against Enoch.
Even if you see dribble penetration, you have to stay home with him. He has been on fire from beyond the arc.
Steve Enoch from the foul line.
And then obviously playing UCF twice, 64-49 win this game.
Over whatever he has left with that ankle. Too strong on the three. Another chance, Steve Enoch to the rim and a blocking foul. REAC conference season where UConn was going with just 6.
And he gave us a smile and said no.
Shoot. White thinking about pulling the trigger. Goes inside the free throw line. Shepard and Hughes going back and forth, the two freshmen. Shepard rejected by Steve Enoch. Adams leaves it for Enoch. React the defense. And then swatted by Washington. Down low to Washington. Matched up against Enoch. And a foul.
And, you know, again, here's the press and UConn getting out on the floor.
With very little depth, early foul trouble.
Prima off a good look from Stephen Enoch.
Facey to a cutting Adams. Kick out, knocked down by Stephen Enoch. That's a big boost to get some offense out of him. And the zone on defense for UConn.
Yeah.
6 straight for UConn.
And
Evans turns the corner, swatted away by Stephen Enoch, the sophomore from Norwalk.
Down 9. I mean, with as dominant as since he's been on the glass.
That's out of bounds off of UConn as Enoch got it blocked from behind and then lost it out of bounds with a minute one to go before the half.
Moved the towel off the ball, let him shoot a little bit.
Enoch against the Cincinnati zone.
The heck of a senior class that he was a part of as well.
Evans misses on the baseline.
Going against Cincinnati. Now the Huskies looking for more magic.
Of USF on the perimeter, and then when they throw the ball into the post, they've
the NCAA tournament. And that, just knowing losing three key players before the season even really got going, and having a lot of guys have to carry a lot of load.
Started 0-2 and losses to Wagner and Northeastern. But
Tulio Da Silva, 21, back into the game for USF. He's Bibby, Ziegler, and Guerrero on the floor for the Bulls. Foul, Guerrero on Enoch as he tried to get to the rim. Strong.
Big 10.
Big 10, thank you. I knew I was missing something.
They're down. Vegas trying to survive a weekend with Bill Walton.
Da Silva. The spin and step back. Guerrero fouled as he got the rebound. Enoch got a piece of him. Paint cut off nicely by Enoch. Bibby from way outside. And came up an inch or two short. Enoch. Right hand off the glass, fight for the rebound.
A lot of screens for him, and he's working very hard. He's got to get some help, though.
There's Thorpe, and a block. We'll get another chance. Kevin Ollie not happy about that. Ruben Guerrero couldn't get the shot to go. Enoch gets the rebound. Hartford, all in best with Tim Welsh. The 6-11 game, the 11 seed. USF Bulls hanging around. Luis Santos will draw the foul as he goes to the bucket. Game for the Huskies. And the Cougars look to build on a lead knocked away by Enoch.
Game, unless it's a health issue or a foul issue.
0 for 5 shooting, 3 turnovers on their last 8 possessions. Make it another one for UConn. Gray can't answer. That's going to be a foul on Bert Colley. Got to the line often. Here's Dotson. He's got too far under the bucket. Knowles put back attempt. Knocked away.
It's loud. There's not near that tonight, but there's a lot of energy and buzz here helping UConn.
Foul called on Stephen Enoch. A ninth straight miss by the Cougars. Enoch gets away from Davis. It rattles around and out. Purvis around Dan Beck. Tries to get it inside. Good save there. But a step on the end line by Stephen Enoch.
Stephen Enoch at 6'11 into the lane. Missed badly there. Clark getting it inside for Moore. Got a good look, but no. Another whistle, 4:10 to go. Purvis with it up top.
I thought he missed Enoch on the first look. He made this a more difficult play, and that could have been an offensive foul.
Jalen Adams on the bench, of course, because of foul trouble. And another tie-up and a whistle on the baseline with 26 seconds to go.
That question is yes, and if there's a member of, you know, the...
And this is a respected crew, Carl Hess, Mike Nance, Ron Groover, they do a really nice job.
Create a little bit more space for that three. The challenge a little easier because Purvis needed to take an extra dribble.
Clark on the back down to the paint to his right. And he got hit. He'll be at the line.